Let's talk about buffer capacity. Buffer capacity is a property of a buffer, and it tells you how much acid or base you can add before the pH starts changing. Basically, as your buffer capacity goes up, which I'm going to abbreviate BC, as your buffer capacity goes up, you can add more of your acid or base before the pH starts changing a lot. That might seem like a pretty vague and qualitative definition, so let's go through an example to see what that might look like exactly. The example we're going to look at is going to be using an acetic acid buffer. So acetic acid is CH3COOH, and we're going to abbreviate that in this talk using HA. And this is an aqueous solution, and that is reversibly reacting to form H plus ion and CH3COO minus, or acetate. And so we're going to abbreviate acetate in this talk as A minus. Some more information about this particular buffer. Acetic acid, the Ka is equal to 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. And if we take the negative log of that, that will give us the pKa, which is also useful. And the pKa of acetic acid is 4.74. So that'll tell us a lot about the behavior of this buffer. And the last thing we need to know for predicting the behavior of our buffer is what the ratio is between our HA and A minus. So we're going to be looking at a buffer where A minus over HA, this ratio, is equal to 1.82. Based on this ratio, we can calculate the pH. So the initial pH of our buffer, before we do anything to it, before we add any acid or we add any base, the initial pH of our buffer we can calculate using the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. And so that equation tells us that pH is equal to pKa plus log of A minus concentration, or acetate, over acetic acid concentration. And if you're not 100% confident with using this equation, or you want to know where it comes from, we actually have separate videos on that, so I would recommend checking those out. In this video, we're just going to use this equation as is. So if we plug in our values here, we get that the initial pKa is equal to 4.74, our pKa, plus log of 1.82, which is our ratio of A minus over HA. So then we know that our initial pH is equal to 5.00. What we're going to do next is we're going to look at two different buffers. And both of them are going to be made with acetic acid and with acetate. And we're going to call them buffer 1 and buffer 2. So buffer 1 has a ratio of A minus and HA that is 1.82. So the pH is going to be 5, and the A minus concentration, before we do anything to it, before we add anything, is 0.90 molar. And the HA concentration is going to be 0.49 molar. And our second buffer that we're going to compare it to, we will call buffer 2. And buffer 2 also has the same ratio of acid to base, except this time both concentrations are going to be 10 times smaller than buffer 1. So our A minus concentration is 0.090 molar, and our acetic acid concentration is 0.049 molar. And what we're going to do here is we're going to see what happens to the pH of both of these. So they both start out with a pH of 5. But how much do they change when we add we're going to add 0.04 moles of a strong base, sodium hydroxide, to 1 liter buffer. So when you do that, well, it's a buffer. We know that it's going to resist the pH change, but what exactly is happening? What's the reaction that goes on when you add this in? So when you add your strong base, which is going to dissociate to form OH minus, it's going to react with the acid in your buffer. So our acid is CH3COOH. And we always assume that a strong base is going to it's going to react irreversibly, so one-sided arrow, with a weak acid. So what happens is this proton is going to react with OH minus, and we're going to get H2O, or water, and we're going to make CH3COO minus. So that's our base. And so we can see that the hydroxide is going to react 1-to-1 with our weak acid, and it's going to produce one equivalent of our base. So now we can use this information to calculate what happens to our buffer when we add 0.04 moles of sodium hydroxide. What's going to happen is it's going to react with our acid, which means the concentration of the acetic acid is going to go down by 0.04 molar. Our new concentration after it's reacted is going to be 0.45 molar. Sorry, I tried to do that in my head. And what happens to our concentration of the base? Remember that when the acid reacts with sodium hydroxide, we actually make more base. So we have to adjust the concentration of A minus upward. It actually makes 0.04 molar acetate when this reaction happens. So our new concentration of our acetate ion is 0.94 molar. So if these are our final concentrations, we can now plug them back in to the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation to get the pH. So the pH of buffer 1, I'll put a little subscript 1, is going to be 4.74, the pKa, plus log of 0.94 molar divided by 0.45 molar. And if we plug that into our calculator, we get that the pH after we add that hydroxide is 5.06. So it's a little bit higher. It went up by 0.06. That makes sense. We do imagine it would be higher. If you add base, it becomes more basic and the pH should go up, but it didn't change a whole lot because it's a buffer. Now let's compare that with what happens to buffer 2. We add 0.04 mole sodium hydroxide to buffer 2. Our acetic acid concentration is going to go down by 0.04 molar. So our new concentration of HA is 0.009 molar. By the same reaction, our base concentration is going to go up, since when the acid reacts, it makes more conjugate base. So we're going to have to add 0.04 molar to A minus concentration, and so the new concentration is going to be 0.13 molar. And we can plug those concentrations into the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation, and we get that pH of our buffer 2 is equal to 4.74, our pKa, plus log of 0.13 molar divided by 0.009 molar. And so that would be, if we plug this into our calculator, this is equal to 1.16. So if we add that together with our pKa, we get that the new pH is 5.90 molar. So the pH changed a whole lot more for buffer 2 than for buffer 1. The pH went up by 0.9 instead of by 0.06. So if we're comparing the buffer capacities of both of these buffers, we would say that buffer 1, well, the buffer changes less when you add the same amount of acid or base. So buffer 1 has the higher buffer capacity. Since you don't want these concentrations, A- and HA, to be too low, the general rule of thumb is that you want your concentrations of HA and A- between 0.10 molar and 1.0 molar. And by following that rule of thumb, you can make a buffer where you don't have to worry too much about adding too much acid or base before your pH changes, since that's usually why you're making a buffer in the first place.